This is how to determine the pKa given initial and one final concentration. What is the pKa of 2-chlorobutanoic acid if a 0.090 molar solution has a conjugate base concentration of 0.010 molar? Okay, well, once again, we're trying to find something to do with Ka, so let's write the definition Ka reaction. All right, there we go. Now, on the initial row, we have 0.090 of our starting acid and no conjugate base or hydronium, and we're told a final concentration of conjugate base, so that would be the butanoic acid once it's lost its proton, and that is 0.010 molar. All right, well, this must be plus 0.010 molar. This must be plus 0.010 molar here under the hydronium, and this must be minus 0.010 molar. So, doing the math, this would be 0.080 molar acid that remains, and my hydronium concentration is 0.010 molar. All right, well, the Ka is just going to be equal to conjugate base times hydronium over starting acid, so that would be 0.010. times 0.010 divided by 0.080. Plugging that into my calculator, I come up with a value of 1.25 times 10 to the minus 3. And of course, the pKa is just equal to the negative log of the Ka. So that would be the negative log of 1.25 times 10 to the minus 3, which turns out to be 2.90. And that's all there is to that.